if we want to say that you're looking for a shape, the shape you're looking for is concentric spheres spreading out and concentric spheres coming back. That would be the shape of simultaneous expansion and contraction. Or a fountain gushing and gathering, but not just upwards. Up and down, it's gushing up and gathering down at the same time, and it's doing that this way, this way, this way, that way, and that way. So it's like a three-dimensional fountain that gushes from the center and gathers to the center. If I had to give a shape to it, it is intriguing to look at the large-scale anatomy of the human brain. I'm not sure that this has anything to do with what I'm describing at all, but there is a general pattern to what your brain does. Sensory input goes, I'm grossly oversimplifying, but to a great oversimplification, sensory input goes up the back of your spinal cord into something called the corona radiata that sort of looks like this. It's right in the center of your brain, and that means the radiating crown, okay? And then it goes into, from there, it is processed in the cortex. And then in the sensory cortex, then it moves over the surface of the brain to the motor cortex. And then the motor cortex sends messages down, once again, down through the corona radiata and down the front of the spinal column and spinal cord and controls the body, roughly speaking. So roughly speaking, you have movement up and down the spinal cord simultaneously, and from the center of the brain out and then from the periphery of the brain in, you have the sensory input and the motor output. And whether this fountain that I'm describing has anything to do with that or not, I don't know, but if you look at a picture of it, it sure looks like a picture of what I just, of a gushing and gathering simultaneously.